Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Redneck Comedy Tour, featuring Stink Fleenan.
You know you're a redneck if you come from a rural area and behave as such.
Halt Coffee and Pie Abernathy. And Larry, the guy who works for the Department of Water and Power.
You tell me how that got in there.
He's right. Who knows how that got in there?
Peter, can we please go now? This is excruciating.
Are you kidding, Brian? These men and their redneck lifestyle really speak to me. This is the greatest show I've seen in years. Not like the last time I was at a comedy club. I hear this guy's hilarious. He played Kramer, you know.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Peter, what the hell are you doing with a pickup truck?
Wait, let me guess. This is because of the Redneck Comedy Festival, isn't it?
Oh, that dog of mine!
Peter, you can't suddenly decide to be a redneck just because of some show.
Some show? Lois, those men showed me the way to an identity I've been searching for my whole life. I am gonna do everything a redneck is supposed to do.
Ugh, this is gonna be more painful to watch than when he ate half a fudgesicle in one bite.
Oh boy, a fudgesicle!
Chris, what happened to the couch?
Dad dragged it out on the lawn because he said that's what rednecks do.
Hey, Meg, come here. Have a seat.
Dad, what are you doing?
Meg, I'm a redneck, which means I am about to do something to you that you will not remember until you're 40. Meg, come back here. I meant sex.
We now return to Carl Sagan's Cosmos, edited for Rednecks.
I'm Carl Sagan. Just how old is our planet? Scientists believe it's 4 billion...
Hundreds and hundreds of years old.
Scientists have determined that the universe was created by a...
God!
Big Bang. If you look at the bones of a
Jesus,
Tyrannosaurus rex, it's clear by the use of carbon dating that
Mountain Dew is the best soda ever made.
Peter, do we have to watch this?
This is what rednecks watch, Brian.
Peter, that's disgusting. Here, spit in this cup instead.
Oh, there's my apple juice.
Stewie, wait, don't.
Where's my money? You gonna give me my money?
Never mind.
Hey, Brian, check it out.
Peter, you painted over the back window. Isn't that dangerous?
I'm a redneck, Brian. We like people driving behind us to know what our beliefs are.
Peter, what the hell? My car!
We buy
damn it! Hey, come back! Oi, japai nai, mani, ido, gujai nyun pai lao, kiko, kutok long ka po mung, damai mai, tom tom!
Oh, sorry, Quagmire.
How the hell am I supposed to get to the airport? I gotta fly a plane in 20 minutes.
Oh, I can drive you. I got a pickup truck, see?
Well, come on!
Quagmire, I am so sorry.
Don't worry about it.
We can go after them.
Don't worry about it. They're tagged. They're tagged. Just get me to the airport. All right, thanks a lot, Peter.
That's all the motivation I need to actually do this.
Did we finish fueling?
Do you see the hose in the plane?
No.
Well, then I guess we're finished.
Thanks, George. You want to say that one more time without the sarcasm?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your... we've got some very strong headwinds. Giggity.
Oh, What the hell? Oh my God, we're going down!
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Secure your own mask first and then assist the child.
But the bag's not inflating!
It's all right. Even though oxygen is flowing, the bag may not inflate.
That was too close.
Sir, we have a confirmed crash. Flight 37 is down.
Well, we'd better alert the mayor. I'll have to interrupt his photo op.
My pet goat. Page one. You know, said my pet goat, I'm sure if I watched Grey's Anatomy, I'd like it, but I just don't have the time. You should make the time, said the farmer.
Our top story. There was drama in the skies of Quahog today as a transnational 767 was forced to make a crash landing.
That's right, Diane. As if the world weren't already scary enough, it seems you can't even get on a plane safely these days. Channel 5 has the spectacular footage. Fortunately, no one was injured. However, using state-of-the-art Channel 5 computer technology, we'll show you how disastrous it could have been. Here's how it would have looked if the plane had crashed into a school. Now here's how it would have looked if the plane had crashed into a school for bunnies. Now here's how it would have looked if the plane had crashed into a school for bunnies, but one passenger had survived, gone home, and mercilessly beat his wife.
I'm alive! But boy, am I angry! Someone's gonna have to pay for this!
Why? Why? Is this because I overcooked the roast?
Powerful stuff. You'd have to be made of stone not to feel saddened by that.
Boy, Quagmire, I'm really sorry they fired you. I feel like this is partially my fault.
Now, Peter, it's perfectly normal to siphon jet fuel from an active runway with the intention of flying a pickup truck.
Look, I know I caused a lot of trouble, but my redneck days are over. No more crotch shots of me getting out of a car.
Well, what are you gonna do now, Quagmire?
Hey, it's all right. I got enough in my savings until I find another job. I'll be fine.
3 weeks later.
Mom! Dad! There's somebody in my treehouse!
Yeah, and there's an annoying little homo screaming in my kitchen. Which one do you think I'm more pissed about?
I'll remind you that I was invited here.
All right, who's up there?
Oh, hey, Peter. Hey, Lois.
Glenn, what are you doing up there?
Oh, I kind of moved in, if that's okay. No airline will hire me after the accident. I'm broke and jobless.
Quagmire, you belong in a tree. You're a nut.
What?
Come on down, Quagmire. You're staying with us.
Oh, great. This is going to be worse than the time I lived with Marley Matlin.
Hi, Stewie.
Oh, come on, Marley. I know you can't hear them, but you've got to feel those things slapping out of there.
Hey, listen, I really want to thank you guys for taking me in my time of need.
Oh, forget it, Quagmire. It's the least we could do after what happened.
Hello? Oh, you must have a wrong number. There's no one here by the name of Long Rod Von Hugendong.
Okay, now add 20.
Okay.
Now multiply it by 4.
Okay.
And what do you got?
8,008.
And what does 8,008 look like on a calculator?
Oh, boob!
Boob, yeah, all right, boob!
What if we had two calculators and we put them next to each other?
Yes, find one, yes?